So, yeah, that's your third law of action movies. Four one-liners. Once again, Steven Seagal movies never have great one-liners. And Bloodsport is a great action movie. Bloodsport had some completely unintentional one-liners, like when Jean-Claude Van Damme's character goes to like the Kumite, this one guy's like, "You're American shit that do make tricks with bricks." And that line is for that. So, like, obviously some great one-liners to do. Yippee-ki-yay, motherfucker. I'll be back. That's just Arnold Schwarzenegger's catchphrase. Oh, that reminds me, another great action movie, Commando. You know why Commando is a great action movie? The completely likable character played by Arnold Schwarzenegger, who I feel is one of the best action movie. And I'm so glad this man is my governor. He's just got some really great one-liners. Like, he just says completely bizarre shit, like,
"Remember how I said I would kill you last? I lied.
And
let off some steam, Bennett."
And that is so horrible in impersonation. Anyway. Oh! So yeah, four rules of action movies, which... Oh, action movie has to be fun. Action movie has to be single-minded. Action movie needs a memorable, fun character, and action movie needs one-liners. The fifth? I personally think an action movie should have a lot of set pieces. The set piece is like jargon, I think. It might be jargon, I don't know. I'm calling it a set piece. They're just like references to action scenes, like, Michael Bay's, for example, like, I think Transformers has at least 12 set pieces, which are all, like, little fights. It's, like, the most of any Michael Bay movie. Michael Bay is the king of action cinema, by the way. Actually, no, he's the duke of action cinema. Because he can get better, because I didn't like Transformers, but Michael Bay, if you're watching this, which I'm sure you're not, I love Bad Boys, and I love Bad Boys 2. I think The Rock is the greatest action movie ever made. So I've seen four of your movies, and I think you can get better for Transformers 2, but... Yeah, you just need to work on it. I'm pretty sure you're going to be saying, "Who's this little shithead thing?" But, oh, I'm sorry, Michael Bay. Action movies need to have a lot of set pieces. That's why the Michael Bay movies are good. They have a lot of set pieces. In comparison, I've seen... Oh! Great idea, great example of why an action movie needs a lot of set pieces. There's this Asian movie, Asian cinema star Jet Li. It's called High Risk. I think that's a much better name than the American title. The American title is just called Meltdown. But High Risk is a way cooler name. It's just this ripoff of Die Hard. There are four set pieces in that entire movie. Actually, four and a half, really. There's this beginning scene where Jet Li is in like the special forces and he tries to defuse a bomb. There's a half one where he chases some guy out into an alley and like kicks him. Then there's this big intrusion where Jet Li and one other guy like drive into the skyscraper that the terrorists have taken over. Gee, I wonder what movie that was. And there's another fight, like Jet Li actually dukes it out like mano a mano with this one guy. That's like a really good fight scene. And then there's finally the Jackie Chan ripoff fights the ultimate villain. That's five set pieces in a 2-hour movie. There's just this part in the middle that goes on for 40 minutes and it's so boring. I remember I rated High Risk a C+ because that scene was just so damn boring. It, like, ruined the movie. I would not recommend it. I just tell someone to go watch Die Hard, like, turn up Die Hard onto Chinese language and put on English subtitles and just watch Die Hard that way. It, you're getting High Risk, but it's a much better movie. But that's really the biggest example. Like, for example, Die Hard, well, honestly, I can say Die Hard had one top set piece, which was the whole movie. Die Hard is a game. That's why Die Hard is highly regarded, because Die Hard never lets up. Granted, I came out of Die Hard just completely exhausted, and I'm like, oh my god, how am I gonna watch these next two movies? But really, when it comes down to it, that's why Die Hard's a good movie. Kill Bill, I think Kill Bill can really get away with less set pieces, because, like, generally, they're really high octane in the story. Kill Bill is interesting enough to warn it. I'm pretty sure that music is drowning out everything I say. Anyway, let me reiterate the laws of action cinema one last time. Needs to be fun. I forgot the rules. I'm just gonna, like, call it the movie. Wow, this really sucks. I totally forgot the rules, but the point is I said them earlier in the movie, so I'll just copy and paste that part of the film. Yeah. That's really it. I hope my listeners did not know you. But then again, if you're watching this, you probably know me in real life, so that's okay. And I'm pretty sure I've rented for about at least 10 minutes, so I'm pretty sure YouTube is just not gonna notice. I'm gonna have to edit down.